In this lecture, we are starting with one problem. Xn is given as this signal, which is starting from minus 1 to 2, and its values are like this. And now problem is to find out the even part and odd part, as well as to find out the Z transform of these three signals. And through that, we will arrive with one property of the Z transform, which is our next topic. So X of n is this. For the odd signal, we have to, for even an odd part of the signal, we have to make X of minus n. Is this visible to all? Raj, is this visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Sir, so thodi copy left kar do, sir. Side ka nahi dikh raha, even part, odd part.
Okay, okay, just. So now X of minus n is nothing but at 0, it will be same. At minus 1, whatever is the value at 1, that will become at minus 1. And this value is minus 1. Because this value is minus 1, same value will reflect over here. And whatever is at 2, it will be at minus 2. And at minus 2, it is 0.5. So we draw 0.5. At minus 3, whatever is the value at 3, 4, 5, and so on, it will repeat at minus 3, minus 4, and minus 5, and so on. Similarly, in the right-hand side, whatever is the value at minus 1, that will reflect at 1, and the value is 2. At minus 2, whatever is the value, here it will reflect at here, 2, 3, and 4. Right? So this will be the X of minus n. And clearly, X of n is not equal to X of minus n. That's why this signal cannot be an even signal. And also, if I fold this signal in magnitude to find out minus X minus n, then this signal at minus 1 will become plus 1, which is not equal to this value 2 at minus 1. That's why it cannot be an odd signal. So this signal is neither even nor odd. It is a composition of even and odd. So we have to now find out the even part and odd part. So the even part is like this. Even part of the signal is equal to X of n plus X of minus n divided by 2. Divided by 2. Right? So now, what is the signal value? For this, always we draw on the right-hand side only because it is an even signal. So it will be symmetrical around this axis, this vertical axis, it will be symmetrical. So for zero value is this at 1 and 0 value is this at 1. So 1 plus 1 divided by 2. This is the formula. 1 plus 1 divided by 2. So it is 1. So at 0, it is 1. At 1, the 1 value is here 2, and here it is minus 1. So 2 minus 1 is 1, and divided by 2 is 1 by 2. So it is 0.5. At 2, it is 0.5, and at 2, it is 0. So 0.5 plus 0 divided by 2 will become 0.25. At 3, this value is 0, this value is 0, and so on, it is 0. So after 3, the value will become 0. Right? So we are now clear that at minus 1, what should be the value? At minus 1, what should be the value? Because this is an even signal, what should be the value? Can anybody say? What should be the value at minus 1? It will be 0.5. Okay. Then at minus 2, it is 0.25. And so on, it will reflect over here. Minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and so on. Right? This is the even part. Right? Now for the odd part, what you can do? X of n minus x of minus n divided by 2. So what you will get? That is what the signal will be look like. At 0, it should be definitely 0 because this is the property of an odd signal. Odd signal is that signal which is mandatorily should have 0 value at n equal to 0. And why this is so? Because the definition of the odd signal is this. This is the definition of odd signal. And this is definition for every n. So let us put here 0. So x of 0 is minus x of minus 0. And x of minus 0 is nothing but x of 0. So we write here x of 0. Now we transfer this x of 0 in the right hand side. So it will be twice x of 0 equal to 0. It means x of 0 should be equal to 0. This is the mandatory condition on the odd signal. If a signal is having a non-zero value at 0 point, at n equal to 0 point, then we say definitely this signal cannot be odd signal, right? So this is the mandatory condition. This is the very necessary condition that it should be 0. So at n equal to 0, it is 0. At n equal to 1, right? Either you can do it like this, that you subtract now at 1. Here it is minus 1. Here it is 2. So minus 1, minus 2. It is minus 3. Divide by 2. Right? It is divide by 2. So it will be minus 3 by 2. So it will be minus 1.5 at 1. At 2, it is... Here 0.5 minus 0. 0.5 minus 0 will become 0.5 divided by 2 will be 0.25. So we write here at 2, 0.25. Right? At 3 onwards, it will become again 0. Why it will become 0? Because you can see here, it is 0 here, it is 0 here. So onwards, it is 0. So here also, onwards, it will be 0. Now, because it is an odd signal, we can easily write at minus 1, the value will become 1.5. At 2, the value will become minus 0.25. At minus 3 onwards, the value will become 0. So this is my odd signal. Right? Am I clear with these two, odd and even part?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now see, this is my x of n. Now this x of n, Z transform I have to find out. What will be the Z transform? Can anybody say? Raksha? Kya hoga beta Z transform iska?
सर वो एक्चुअली आपकी जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म वाली क्लासेस मैंने ली नहीं थी, बीच में मेरी तबीयत खराब थी तो मैंने फूरियर पढ़ लिया था, आपने पहले वो पढ़ा दिया।
ओके रेखा
सर मैंने भी नहीं ली आपकी जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म वाली क्लास।
अरे बच्चे, कोई बताएगा जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म क्या होगा इसका? बहुत सिंपल है, डेल एन का जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म पता है, 1 होता है। ये डेल एन के कॉम्बिनेशन से ही तो बना है सिग्नल। डेल एन का ट्रांसफॉर्म क्या होता है? 1 with ROC as mod of all Z plane. ROC is whole Z plane, right? This is the del n. This is the del n signal. And what is this signal? This signal is nothing but twice of. So I am writing here X of n. I am writing here X of n in terms of del n. So the first value is twice del n plus 1 because at n equal to minus 1. Then n equal to 0, so it will be del n. Then n equal to 1, so it will be del n minus 1. And value is minus 1. And then the at 2, so value is 0.5. So 0.5 plus del n minus 2. See here how I return. This value is at minus 1, right? So we write n plus 1 and the value is 2, right? So twice del n plus 1. This value is del n. This value is del n minus 1, but the value is minus 1. So it will become minus del n minus 1. This value is 0.5 del n minus 2. So that I have written over here, right? Now we just find out the Z transform of this, right? Now it is a little bit cumbersome over here. So I am taking here this x of n. So x of z, we know that transform of del n. Transform of del n is z. Del n is 1, right? Transform of del n is 1. So here in place of del n, the z transform is 1. In place of del n plus 1, the transform will become 2z raised to power 1, right? Whatever is after n, it is plus 1. So we write the power of that. So z raised to power 1, right? We will cover this. Actually, this is a time shifting property. So we will cover that property also. So here it is 2z raised to power 1 plus 1 for del n, and then minus del n minus 1. After n, it is minus 1. So write z to the power minus 1 plus 0.5 into z to the power minus 2. Is this clear? Method is clear. Your fundamental should be very clear. And it will help you in the placement also. Because basically the basics are asked. Nobody asks after in the time of placement, nobody will ask that do this derivation or do this problem or draw the graph of this and blah, blah, blah. They will always ask basics of basic subjects also, right? And one of the subject is signal and system, right? So be conscious about this subject. So it is 2z plus 1 minus z inverse plus 0.5 z to the power. Plus 1 by z plus 0.5 divided by z. Now, can anybody give, or rather, Raksha? Aap ye bataiye bache, ye kis value ke liye infinite dega? Z की किस वैल्यू के लिए ये x of z infinite देगा?
सर थोड़ी सी कॉपी ऊपर शिफ्ट कर दो.
Z की किस वैल्यू के लिए ये x of z infinite होगा?
जीरो के लिए, one upon z है.
हाँ, z equal to zero के लिए. और भी एक और वैल्यू और है.
Infinite.
Yes, infinite. क्या इन दोनों वैल्यू के अलावा कोई और वैल्यू है जेड की जिस पर ये इनफाइनाइट आ जाए?
नो सर.
नहीं है. तो अगर मैं इन दोनों पॉइंट को छोड़ दूं तो मेरा रीजन ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस फाइंड आउट हो गया. रीजन ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस जेड का वो वैल्यूज होती है, जेड का वो रीजन होता है जहां पर एक्स ऑफ जेड फाइनाइट आ जाए. Right? तो हमने रिवर्स इंजीनियरिंग कर ली. रिवर्स इंजीनियरिंग क्या की? हमने वो पॉइंट्स दे दिए जहां पर इनफाइनाइट है. राइट? तो इनफाइनाइट वाले पॉइंट हटा दो. तो कैसे हटाएंगे? लिखेंगे जीरो लेस देन मॉड ऑफ जेड लेस देन इनफाइनाइट. तो इसमें क्या हो गया? जीरो और इन्फिनिटिव हट गए, बाकी सारे पॉइंट्स जेड के आ गए. राइट? सो दिस इज द आरओसी ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्सप्रेशन. X of Z की ROC ही होगी. और ROC मैंने बता चुका हूँ पिछले लेक्चर्स में. अगर आपने अटेंड नहीं किया है तो जस्ट गो थ्रू द YouTube चैनल ऑफ माइन एंड सब्सक्राइब इट सो दैट यू विल गेट द नोटिफिकेशन टाइमली. राइट? सो X of Z विल बी दिस वैल्यू. राइट? नाउ आवर टास्क इज टू फाइंड आउट द X of Z, x of even part of z and x of odd part of z. This was the our problem, right? So we have completed with finding out even and odd part. We have completed with the finding out x of z. Now comes the even part of z transform and odd part of z transform. Even part is this, right? This is the even part. This one is the even part. So the transform of this, I am writing over here this transform. Transform of this will be x of even part of z is equal to x of even part of z equal to values are -2.25. So it will be 0.25 z to the power -2. बहुत सिंपल है बच्चे, देख लो क्या करना है. n की वैल्यूज देखिए, n की वैल्यूज क्या है, यहाँ पर 0.25 के नीचे क्या लिखा हुआ है, -2. तो यहाँ पर मेरे को क्या लिखना पड़ेगा, 0.25 और z की वैल्यू प्लस
n प्लस 2.
यहाँ पे एक्चुअली में प्लस क्यों लिख रहे हैं, क्योंकि एक्चुअली में x ऑफ n z टू द पावर -n होता है. फॉर्मूला जो होता है ट्रांसफॉर्म का वो ये है, x of z equal to this value, z to the power minus n है, right? इस वजह से यहाँ पर n की जो भी values यहाँ पर है उसका just opposite sign यहाँ पर लिख, right? तो हम easily यहाँ पर लिख सकते हैं 0.25 z to the power 2. अब मैं graph की तरफ देख रहा हूँ और लिख मैं इधर रहा हूँ, right? तो I will show the expression also, 0.25 z to the power plus 2, then 0.5 z to the power plus 1, then 1 into z to the power 0, that is 1, plus 0.5 z to the power minus 1, plus 0.25 z to the power minus 2, and so on, it is 0. So that is the expression. Is it easy to write through the graph itself? You can see and you can write it. Right? Now we go to the odd part of z. Now see, this is the odd part. This one is the odd part, right? So I'm writing now. I will show you that also what I have written. Here it is starting from minus 2 and value is minus 0.25. So it will be minus 0.25 into z to the power plus 2 because the value of n is minus 2. So it is plus 2. Then plus 1.5 z to the power plus 1. Then plus 0 into z to the power 0. So it will become 0. Then minus 1.5. Minus 1.5 into z to the power minus 1. And then last is at 2.25. So it will become 0.25 into z to the power minus 2. Right? So this is the value we got. Right? This is the value we got. Is this visible now? More visible, I think.
हेलो हेलो
राज, अटेंडेंस ले लिया?
हेलो, अटेंडेंस हो गई क्या?
नहीं ब्रो, तू ले ले यार। नहीं, मैंने नहीं ली, तू ले ले।
ले ले भाई, सागर ले ले। अरे
ले ले
मैं
ऋषभ, ले ले
कॉल,
ऋषभ, ले ले ऋषभ,
ले ले यार, मैं कॉल पे हूँ। रुक जा।
हाँ ले रहा हूँ भाई, ले रहे हैं, रुक जा। राज, हेलो
क्या हुआ? अरे
राज,
हाँ बोल। कोई बोल रहा था शायद, मैं कॉल पे था, सॉरी।
ऋषभ ले ली क्या? हेलो,
हेलो, यस सर।
अबे सर कहाँ पे है?
अटेंडेंस हो गई क्या?